On the Move host Donna Yeager visits with Jeanne Kennedy, Phil Schultz, and Dr. Walter Bortz to discuss their involvement with senior health issues. As clinical professor of medicine at Stanford University, Dr. Bortz will be speaking about diabetes and the art of aging. Now please welcome Jeanne Kennedy, Phil Schultz, and Dr. Walter Bortz with our host, Donna Yeager.
Hi, I'm Donna Yeager with On the Move, and I'd like to welcome our very distinguished guest, Dr. Walter Bortz.
Hi, kid.
And Jeanne Kennedy, welcome.
Good to be here.
And Phil Schultz, welcome, Phil.
Thank you.
Now, I'd like to start by saying that Dr. Bortz, we have known each other for about 5 years, approximately.
Seems like about that.
Right. And I have just enjoyed meeting with you and going to lunch with you and talking, and you're such an interesting gentleman, and you have just a wealth of information that I love hearing about, and so I'm very thankful that we've been friends for that long.
Well, you're sweet. You inspire me, as you know. I write a blog for Huffington, and you were the topic of one of them.
Okay.
Said, I'm never going to complain again.
And I love the photograph. You were very gracious and invited us to your home, and I'm so happy that I got to meet Jeanne. This is wonderful. We had a really wonderful visit.
That we did. That was wonderful.
It was great. And then I also have a photograph of you and I when we were visiting that day, and that was just so much fun. I think you're the only person that I know that has a wheelchair accessible home. Mm-hmm. Literally, everybody else has steps. Oh, no, you do too. I can get into your place, Phil. I digress. Anyway, it's very rare that the wheelchair can get in to most people's homes. But I'm very happy. Happy that we've been able to.
Santa Claus comes down the chimney, though. He has
Ooh.
Access.
Oh, okay, there you go. Now we know. Thank you. Very good. And I want to thank Phil for coming today also, because, we've known each other since the mid-80s. Isn't that incredible? I know, it doesn't seem like that long.
No, doesn't.
You were a mere child when I met you.
So, yeah.
But actually, our friend Mark invited me when we had a situation where you were having a wonderful Bible study. And so we had a lot of fun meeting with you and hearing pearls of wisdom coming out of you.
That's all I had.
Oh, and you still have pearls of wisdom. But maybe actually, Jeanne, would you mind holding up that picture for us, please? Right there. There, kind of angle it downward there, or the other way. There we go. Now the camera can see it. Because Mark is our friend on the left side of the picture, and he's the gentleman that introduced me to you. And then you were gracious enough to be the minister of my wedding. How would you say that? Was that
okay? Sure, perfect.
Yeah. And so maybe we'll show the wedding picture really quick there. Thank you. There we go. That's the wedding picture. And there's Jerry. Jerry, our crew member, is here today. So we've been friends for even longer than that. Anyway, thank you very much. Thank you. But I have been so happy that we've been able to talk about a lot of the activities that you're involved with, because I love medicine. I think because of my physical disability, I had to learn about myself and learn how to be my own advocate, for medicine and in a medical way. So I've always loved learning about medicine, and you make it fun. You make it so that the layperson can really understand what's going on, and making it easier. And we're actually talking about diabetes today. And this is the book right here that you've written. And I read the book, and it is, we could zoom in on that if we could. The book right there on the table, there we go. Thank you. Because it's just full of really important information, and it kind of tells people how to kind of learn what some of the signs are. Maybe could you tell us what some of the early warnings are?
Well, diabetes, unfortunately, is the epidemic of our time.
Yeah.
Right. It started when I was in medical school, which was 50 years ago. We rarely saw a case. Now it's rare to see a person who doesn't have diabetes. I wrote an article, said, gonna be the last person who does not have diabetes.
Wow.
It is going worldwide. The National Geographic had an article called Globesity, which means that obesity is, and then diabetes follows right soon thereafter.
Wow. Is that right? Oh my goodness.
I wrote the book and likened it to a fire. So that your fire is catching, and unfortunately the fire department is not as good as it ought to be.
Oh.
You're much better not getting it, and that's my philosophy about everything in medicine is don't get it.
Yeah, that's true. That's very true. And actually, right before I interviewed you the first time on the show, I think it was like the week before, you went and did the Boston Marathon. How many years did you do that? It was,
well, I've run 45 marathons, but that was in 2014.
Wow.
So it's 3 years now.
Yeah.
That was a big day.
Yeah. And I was frightened because the bombing happened that day. And I was worried for you, you know, as everyone was, so.
I'm so slow that I was way back. So I heard about it later in the day.
Yeah. Look at those beautiful medals. Oh my goodness. They're kind of weighing you down there. They're gorgeous. Wow. Just very impressive. Oh my goodness.
Well, one of my sayings is the devil can't hit a moving target.
Oh, there you go.
So you got to keep moving.
That's true. Hence the name of the show, On the Move.
On the Move. Well said.
That's good. Okay. I feel better now. Thank you. I will keep moving. That's for sure. And you tell us, Jeanne, a little bit about how you met Walter.
Oh, well, I decided at a rather advanced age that it was time that I reached out a little bit because my life had gone a little bit astray with a partner who had Alzheimer's.
Oh, yeah.
And so I went online, and that was not easy. And there was one person I knew there.
Yeah.
But I thought, oh, but I already know him, and probably he wouldn't like me that way, I wouldn't like him that way. So I didn't do anything about it. And then I went through what so many people do go through, where it's pretty difficult. Yeah. And then I thought, oh, I'll tell him I'm on. So I wrote him a note, and he didn't answer me for 8 days.
Oh, wow.
I thought, well, I probably didn't like him anyway. So then he called.
But you actually knew him at the hospital.
I knew him even before I worked at the hospital because way, way back, he was a doctor of a very good friend of mine that had a problem with alcoholism.
Oh.
And her husband and I and the family, we all counted on him to tell us what to do and to help us to do it.
Wow.
It was not always successful, but he had the right advice.
Wow. Oh, my goodness.
And then, of course, I did know him in the hospital, and we served on some boards together.
Oh, okay. Great. Excellent.
And he was the one that suggested when I brought up the fact that I wanted to put a health library in Stanford Health Library free to the public.
Right.
He said, get it in the shopping center.
Yeah.
And I thought, Stanford Shopping Center isn't going to want to have a library in there, but they did. Rosemary McAndrews was the manager, and she was way ahead of her time.
Oh, that's fantastic.
Yeah, I thought so.
Well, and I know that Phil had some questions regarding what the, go ahead. Diabetes regarding, yeah.
Oh, a curious thing in regards to the legs and the neuropathy in the legs and whether that actually, because I haven't been diagnosed as diabetic, but that's what's been happening. And I have been tested, and I come out not having diabetes, but I am curious about this thing and how, if there's a chance to have a renaissance.
If you had diabetes, maybe we could do something.
Okay, I have diabetes.
Well, certainly diabetic neuropathy is one of the bad parts of that disease. It hurts your eyes, your kidneys, and your legs, and that's not a good combination.
Yeah.
And like other things in medicine, we have things we're not very good at. Mm. And once it hits your nerves, it means those nerves have been damaged. And it oftentimes hurts. I hope yours doesn't hurt.
Well, it doesn't. It doesn't hurt, but if I drive, which I do very little of now, I have to be very careful that I don't kill too many people.
That's not a good idea.
No, we don't want to do that. But you're saying that that is one factor that could be with diabetes or possibly related.
Well, always you try to control the blood sugar as much as you can.
Oh, okay.
And the big thing, of course, initially is insulin. You don't have to take insulin, I hope.
No.
And then there are a series of pills and diet. But I'm a big exercise guy. I think exercise is the answer to the world's problems.
Yeah.
So keep moving, as Donna.
That's right.
Donna's all championing us.
That's right. Well, I love swimming, so that's my big thing in the morning. You know, every morning it's important to get at that swimming pool, and 6 a.m. we're first ones in the parking lot to get in the water, so it's wonderful. But there's so many important pieces of information in the book. I know that you said that if there's a choice of using an elevator or walking up a flight of stairs, you say go up the flight of stairs every time.
Look for opportunities to move. Don't park your car as close as you can. Park it on the other valley over there.
Right.
The body's meant to move. You know that.
Yeah, that's right. It's true. But there's so many important pieces of information in there. It really is. It's a wonderful book. Very impressive. And you've written quite a few that are, you know, very informative. And I'm just really enjoying every time I read another book. And you're having another one coming out soon, so that's great. Excellent. And then you you have a lot of speaking engagements that you do as well, right?
I just gave a talk up in San Rafael on intimacy. And I said, what do I know about that? I used to know about that when I was 15, but I'm learning again now.
Yeah, good.
That's a good thing to learn about.
That's right. A refresher course. You're never too old. That's wonderful.
That's Bortz's law. It's never too late to start, but it's always too soon to stop.
Oh, words to live by. I like that. Exactly. And then I like the biography that explains, oh my goodness, you have traveled all over the world. You've shown me beautiful photographs of being in Africa. Mm-hmm. And oh, it's so beautiful. The photos are phenomenal. They're really wonderful. And that's a great photo of you too there. I like that. And you look so schnazzy in your sports car here?
Well, I keep the top down whenever I can.
I know. You pulled up in front of the Stanford Shopping Center a couple months ago, and it's like, wow, Walter, you're traveling in style. Very nice. I love it.
My car's nice, but you have to pedal.
Oh, yeah.
That's the trouble with it. I can't afford an engine.
Oh, I see. So kind of like a Flintstones
one. Yeah, exactly.
There you go. Whatever works.
Can you share a little bit about your book about intimacy?
Oh, no.
Well, I say I'm 87, and I used to know what I was doing when I was 15. Mm-hmm. But I'm not 15, and I've lost some of the panache. So I'm looking for suggestions. I need volunteers, and I kind of hope Jeanne will help me volunteer here.
I think you've got plenty of panache.
Okay, we're losing the family rating here rapidly. I know I'm blushing. Anyway, well, Jeanne, tell me about your lovely home that you remodeled. It's really an amazing story.
Well, it wasn't my home. It was the university's home.
You were borrowing it.
yes, right. And it was called Hoover House, and I got the time I was married to the president, and so we were supposed to live there, and we did. Wow. But it took a year to get it back in shape. It had really been run down. Wow. So it was, and I was working full-time at the hospital.
Yeah.
So I had sort of two full-time jobs to oversee the house renovation and work in the hospital. Of course, wow. The hospital had to come first, so.
That was a big job, though.
It was. It was a big job. 18,000 square feet.
Wow. Yeah.
It was quite a job.
It's beautiful. We saw pictures of it.
Yeah. It's a fantastic
very
house.
Pretty.
Built in 1935 by Herbert Hoover for his wife, Lucille.
Wow. Cool. I was impressed. I didn't realize. I had no idea that it was right here.
Yeah, right? Center of the Stanford campus on a hill.
Wow. That is so neat. Yeah. Wonderful.
It's the president's house, is
yes.
it not?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm. It is.
And this is an incredibly small world. Phil's mom, you used to take your mom to see Dr. Bortz. When, you know,
I shared that with him. Yeah.
How long ago was it?
Well, she, died, I think, in around 2006.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
But she was very, she loved your intelligence.
Oh, yeah.
Oh. So I had an advantage.
Yes, you did.
Oh, that's wonderful.
Well, I used to be interested in aging because it was somebody else. Now all of a sudden, I recognize it's me. So it's now on the job training that I'm working on.
Well, you're an expert.
We're all getting there. Yeah. We get old pretty fast.
Yep.
You're not getting old.
I am.
You're younger than you used to be.
Oh, thank you. I'm very, very good at whatever. Anyway, I'm tongue-tied. But I was really hoping that we could talk a little bit more about the fact that so many books, and it's just amazing to me the wealth of information that you have in your head. I think that's probably why you need to write so many books, because...
Well, I've been beautifully trained. I've worked with Nobel Prize winners,
and
I'm at Stanford, and Stanford is a joy and a treasure for our whole community. So I've had numerous friends, and I'm giving a course. Thank you for the opportunity.
Right.
This winter, I'm giving a course called The Science of Longevity.
Oh.
And it's a 10-week course. It's open to the public. It's a continuing education. So I look forward to that. Jeanne's going to hold my hand during
that.
Yeah, I have to pay for the privilege, though.
Oh, okay. Well, I want to come, too.
You can.
That sounds wonderful. And you told me that your father was also a doctor.
My dad was a big deal.
Yeah.
He was Harvard all the way.
And wow.
I was his little kid.
Yeah.
And so I became a doctor before I even knew it. It was in my umbilical cord. But I became a doctor because of my father, and I also have a son who's a doctor. So we're proud of that heritage.
Oh. That's fantastic.
Something to be proud of.
Yeah, very proud. Well, I'm sure you're a proud papa.
Well, my son, the doctor, you'd like to be able to swagger that.
That's right. Well, speaking of being very proud, you also are very active at writing a blog, right, with Huffington Post.
Every Tuesday I write a blog, the title of my book, Dare to be 100.
Yeah.
And they all reflect generally on getting older. I find it easy to talk about that. So tomorrow's Tuesday, and yeah. I already am going to planning my blog.
All right.
It gives a chance for that.
That's fantastic. That's okay. It's lovely music. We'll be serenaded for a moment.
Can we dance?
Yeah. Oh, that's so pretty. Okay. Anyway. So tell us a little bit more, Jeanne, about all the activities that you've been involved with, which are many, many,
yes,
many.
Well, I'm now retired from the hospital job, but
yeah.
I did patient relations and community relations at Stanford Hospital for over 25 years.
Fantastic.
And it was wonderful because I could design my own job.
Yeah.
And nothing that I did had been done before.
Uh-huh.
So the first thing was to really start a patient advocacy program. And I used to talk on just what you said, how to be your own best advocate. This
right.
is desperately important. You, when you go to the hospital, you have to be your own best advocate. It's good if you can bring someone with you to be your advocate.
Exactly.
And it's important. And patients have rights, and they don't always know them. So I tried very hard to stress that you have the rights, you
right.
have to use them.
And you know, along those lines, we need to emphasize that the older you get, the harder it is to keep your balance. I'm really worried because there are a lot of family members right now that are having kind of balance equilibrium problems, and it's important. I always say, high stepping, that's my saying. So if you keep kind of raising your feet up and not dragging them, I think that that helps from falling. A lot of our wonderful, loving friends at church are having a difficult time right now because of, you know, maybe there's a little numbness in their feet, and it's, you know, it's just those stupid little rugs that, well, this is a perfect example. This kind of a rug. You don't want to trip on it, and I think they're probably up there. I don't know what the statistics are, but they're probably up there with the, you know, a large majority of the falls that happen.
No, absolutely, you're right.
Oh,
and
yeah.
I have balance problems, and most people my yeah. age have balance problems.
Right.
But what you said, I had a runner, a friend of mine that was a runner, mm-hmm. and he said that old runners stop lifting their feet, and so that's when he said, lift your feet.
Right.
But the other thing to think about is when you're seniors, put your heel down first and your toes second. I find lifting my feet simpler.
Yeah. Right, right.
But you're absolutely right.
Right.
Before I came here, I was just cleaning out a little area.
Oh.
And I completely lost my balance.
Oh, no.
And I fell well.
Oh.
Good.
Yeah.
That's the second best thing.
Yes.
If you can't
I heard
fall
that rolling
well.
Helps.
I learned that at Stanford.
Oh, good. Yay. Yeah. And we're
in a dance class.
So I want to thank you so very much. Thank you for joining us. It's amazing.
Sorry about this.
No. Very pretty
bless
song.
You.
Thank you.
But actually, we want to say one more time what your address is.
My
email right.
Gmail is Dr. W. Bortz at Gmail.
Okay, good, good.
That does it.
Okay, and I want to thank you very much, Jeanne, for joining us, too.
Donna, it's a pleasure
thank
to be
you.
Here.
Thank you.
You run a great show.
Thank you. And thank you, Dr. Bortz. Thank you, Walter.
Privilege to be your friend, kid.
Thank you. And thank you so very much. Until next time, I'm Donna Yeager. Have a wonderful day.
We're on the moon. We're striking out to set the pace. We all can choose to make a difference. Our time is overdue. If we collect our dreams, take them on the moon. We're rolling and we're walking, but we're not sitting still. There's a world of adventure to explore. We're signing and we're talking from New York to Brazil, from Canada on out to Singapore. We're on the move to make this world a better place. We're on the move, we're striking out to set the pace. We all can choose to make a difference. Our time is overdue. If we collect our dreams, take them on the move. On the move to make this world a better place. We're on the move. We're striking out to set the pace. We often choose to make a difference. Our time is overdue. If we collect our dreams, take them on the move.
Got it. If you see us in your businesses or see us on TV, don't be surprised, because you'll see us there again.
And again.
Folks are showing our abilities and building.
Hey, we're on the move to make this world a better place. We're on the move, we're striking out to set the